Good afternoon, everyone. Hello, welcome. My name's Simon Boyle. This is Ben Graveston, otherwise known as James Martin lookalike. Welcome to Brigade. We're up on the first floor of Brigade, and this is the Beyond Food Foundation Apprenticeship Week live stream. So welcome, and it's a National Apprenticeship Week event. We are probably the oldest apprentices in the world. So I'm 48 years old, and I first became an apprentice when I was 16. So I worked that out, 1989, I think it was. I did it at the Savoy Hotel in London, which is pretty good. Ben, when did you do your apprenticeship?
Qualified 2 years ago.
Yeah. So 2 years ago, and you don't. How old are you, Ben?
You're 43.
43. So the idea that you have to be 16, 17 years old to become an apprentice is you know, unfounded. And actually, you can become an apprentice whenever you want. And actually, as we want to think about reskilling ourselves, rethinking our careers, or if you're coming out of school thinking, I don't know what to do, I haven't got any great qualifications, an apprenticeship is a great thing to do. And you can do it in any vocation.
Absolutely.
So I'm thinking, you know, hairdressing, obviously hospitality, things like car mechanics, all those vocational employment opportunities. So, Ben, what kind of led you to kind of be interested in apprenticeship?
Well, I was a soldier for many, many years. Then I was retired from the military due to a quite serious tropical infection. I had to spend 10 months at a mental health hospital, which was down here in London, so south of London, and then got introduced to Simon whilst I was down there. And the rest is history, basically. I came to Simon and did my apprenticeship.
So the Beyond Food Foundation is really trying to really help people that have gone through a vulnerable situation. Sometimes deep trauma, like being a soldier in Afghanistan, can you imagine? Or just, you know, maybe not having the right support system around you to kind of make you feel that actually you can make those best foot forward decisions in your life. So Beyond Food is here. There's loads of organisations out there that can really help you. Anyway, should we get cooking? We wanted to do something about really food because I'm a chef and I love food. I'm so lucky to have food in my life, as I am the music I love and the people in my life, my friends and family. But food is one of those things I cook every day. I love it. You know, I'm not the thinnest and slimmest guy in the world. But what we thought we'd do is do two lovely dishes. We did this charity book in lockdown number one. How many lockdowns are we in?
Three lockdowns.
We're in extended three lockdown, aren't we? Called Feast for Purpose, and what I did is I reached out to loads of amazing chefs to say, you know, can you donate a recipe that we can put in a book and sell it, and all the money from this book will help to go to our apprenticeships. So it's very apt that we should do two recipes. So we've chosen two today, haven't we? We've got Ben Tish's Aubergine Parmesan, which is incredibly simple, but it's absolutely delicious. And then we've got Andy Astin from Baxter Story. Ben is from Norma. Restaurant called Norma in London, amazing. And then we've got Andy Astin from Bar+Kitchen Story, which is a kind of commercial corporate catering organisation, but it does loads of amazing work with the NHS at the moment. And Andy's really, specifically really into kind of healthy vegetarian food. So we've got one of his dishes, of which I have slightly, because we've got long, fasted us a little bit just to try and get it into the 10 or 15 minutes of this live cast. So first of all, just tell us what we're doing.
So it's aubergine parmesan. If you think the essence of a lasagna, you take away the pasta sheets and add aubergine here as the kind of pasta sheet layers, you build it up the same way. So we're just going to quickly top and tail the aubergine. We're going to kind of do a bit of safety thing, and I'll cut a little bit at the bottom, then you'll cut down. So I'll just quickly show you how to do that.
So it's basically a bit like a lasagna, but there's no pasta in it.
Nice little bit off there. So when you cut down, it's not going to fall over and you're not going to cut your fingers off.
I will get your tray ready for you.
Thank you very much, Jeffy.
So this is the tray we're going to cook the aubergine in. The whole bacon. And we've also got another tray to roast our aubergine. Now you could pan fry these, and actually that would be awesome, but actually quite simple. We're using big trays because we're using commercial oven, but a little bit of olive oil, some salt, some pepper, and then we'll just pop them on. olive oil, more seasoning, and into a hot oven. And actually, if it's hot enough, about 180, they will roast very happily and do the same job as pan frying. But you'll be able to use a little bit less olive oil, which is always good. Okay, so we just move them around, season them up. Into the oven. I've always wanted to say this. Here's some we prepared earlier. Ba-da-ba-da. Okay, so Ben, could you just grate some Parmesan? Okay. Now here, this is magic. Okay. So tins of tomato, the cheapest you can find. It doesn't matter. Right. In natural juice, I put about 6 tins into here yesterday, and I just cooked it for about an hour and a half. Just low, and what happens is the water evaporates and you're left with this really sweet, rich tomato flavour. And what you end up with this, and you can buy this and it's a bit like a passata, but actually doing it yourself is much cheaper. And reduced it by half. So we started here and we end up with a bit here. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna just a little bit of tomato going through. And we're gonna layer it. Really simple. So there's no pasta, just aubergine. You could be really adventurous and put some parma ham or even sliced ham, something like that. But actually this is really good, that is. Okay.
Basil on there,
sir? Yeah, I'll put a little bit more tomato. Like so. We'll just do this nice and quick. Loads of basil. Lots of flavour, lots of flavour, lots of flavour. We're not adding any salt because we've seasoned our aubergine. So then we're going to go, these are breadcrumbs, these are panko breadcrumbs. Fresh breadcrumbs are absolutely fine. Lots of. Yeah. And then, we've got some burrata. Now actually burrata is a bit like a mozzarella, so you can use it. It's a lot softer. This is sheep's milk. So we're going to pull that in. So there's no sauce required here because that cheese is going to do the job. And then we've got Parmesan cheese.
Just going to wash my hands.
Yeah. And then we're going to go for another layer. Okay. Now we're doing this really quick, but obviously you can take your time, enjoy it. That's what cooking's all about, is taking your time and enjoying it. And when I can say that, when the restaurant's closed.
And it's not rammed.
When the restaurant's busy, it's a slightly different ballgame.
Things
can be
your
section, yeah. So again, a little bit more tomato. Now we don't want it to be sloppy, so that's why I'm not adding too much. And don't forget, this is quite rich. So again, just push it all in. Lots more basil. Okay. A bit more burrata. If you haven't seen this sort of thing, you think, oh, that looks disgusting, try it. That's what food's all about.
It's really creamy, mozzarella-y type flavour. If you like mozzarella, even a little more. Yeah.
Excellent. Good lad. More breadcrumbs. The breadcrumbs are going to soak up the juices, and it's going to hold the whole thing together. So we've got lots of breadcrumbs. More Parmesan. Last layer of aubergine. What did you wake, Ben, tell me. Woke up this morning, what did you think?
Up into the smoke, up into London to cook with you.
Feel good?
Yeah, absolutely. Well, I'm going to be absolutely honest. I do have quite a rare disease, and so I've not been allowed out since last March. But thankfully, I was at the top of the food chain for my inoculations. So I've had my second one now. So I'm now a veteran out since last March. This is the furthest I've been since last March.
Yeah. Well, that's good. That's great. The reason why I asked the question is this morning, I was like a lot of people, I think you kind of get when you wake up and you think, we're going to go a bit more breadcrumbs and then finish off with cheese and olive oil. And, you know, sort of felt slightly unfocused, you know, and then it was like, okay, I'm coming into work, that's great. And, you know, just keeping busy doing something, whether it's cooking at home, if you've got the opportunity to go to work, great. If you don't, then, you know, go online, learn something, do some research. That's brilliant, thank you. A little bit of time, thank you.
We've got a question.
Yeah.
When is the next apprentice recruitment?
Good question. So the next apprentice recruitment is going to be, well, we're now starting, it'll be April, we'll be looking for people, applications, meeting, whether it's key workers, social workers, schools, colleges. So if you are interested, I would say jump on the website now, email us at info@beyondfood.org.uk and stick your name in the hat now. But we will be fast recruiting the whole of April. And our apprenticeship starts on the 1st of July this year. So we are looking for quite a lot of people to help. And it's not just about apprentices. That key work that Beyond Food does is called Fresh Life. And Fresh Life is life-changing, isn't it?
Absolutely.
It absolutely gets you to focus on standing on your own two feet, focusing on anything that you need to help you be in the right place to join the employment market. This goes in the oven. And we will come back to that in a minute. Thank you, Ben.
Sweet.
Ben will clear up. Now we're going to do this little healthy salad. Sorry. So this is Andy's, and Andy's is slightly different, but I'm going to do a quick version of it. Firstly, I'm going to finely chop some onions. Like so. One onion, two halves. I'm going to make a little bowl here, a little spice bowl. I'm going to use this to cook. So in goes that. Anybody know what that is? That is fresh turmeric. Really good for your gut. It's a great spice. We have it in a powdered version quite often, but this is fresh. So I'm going to put in, and I'm not going to peel it. I'm just going to add a fine microplane. Just get a whole one in there. It's an amazing spice flavor that you'll really recognize. It's really good for your gut health. I'm also going to add some ginger, so you will know that. It's a little bit more, you probably see it like that. Sometimes it's a bit fatter. Great pungent flavor. Again, absolutely really good for you.
You ready for another question?
Yeah, go for it.
How can I get involved? Are you looking for volunteers?
Yes, we're always looking for volunteers. Beyond Food is actually quite a small charity with big ideas. We're wanting to grow and scale ourselves. And this year, whereas last year we were kind of working, helping all of our beneficiaries and outwardly other people, this year we've been obviously supporting our own beneficiaries, but also strengthening ourselves. We always want people to help us, whether it's mentoring, raising money, actively doing something in the charity. If you've got a skill, for a great example, if you're a psychologist, we've got loads of beneficiaries that need some extra support, is one way. If you are interested in online production that we're just testing at the moment, loads of ways to get involved. So that's the ginger. I've got the ginger and the turmeric in there. I'm going to add a little bit of lemon zest.
I've got a question for Ben about the cooking parmigiana.
Oui.
How long did you say in the oven and what temperature?
About 20, 25 minutes in the oven, 180, and then you'll be able to check it because it'll get a really nice golden kind of sheen on the top. It's crusty, gnarly, beautiful, and then when the time gets cooking, you can start smelling it out, and the aromats and the ambience of it is just amazing.
Thanks, Ben. So here I've got a little bit of chilli. So I've got everything there, what I need. I'm looking around here. This is called za'atar. I'd never even heard of it until I saw Andy's recipe. It's a Middle Eastern spice. I love ras el hanout, but this is really good. Almost smells like tea. It's got quite a lot of Mediterranean herbs in there. So really quite very, very nice. I'm going to put probably 2 teaspoons of that in there. Okay, what else am I going to put in there? Ah, I've got a couple of cardamom pods. You'll see them like that. Okay, I'm simply just going to bash them. Okay, just shake them up a bit. Take the shell away. I'm left with these little black seeds. If you're interested in food, and I mean, like seriously, if you're interested in things, cooking could be a good opportunity for you. If you don't want like the heat in the kitchen, front of house, hospitality is an awesome, awesome industry to get into. And don't think for a second that it's dead, because there's absolutely no way dead. Right, this is what I need. I've got some olive oil going into a pot pan. I've got two other pans here, and I'm going to put a bit of oil in there as well. I'm going to put my spice mix with the onions in. A little bit of shaky.
I don't really want to get these too hot. I want to soften the onion, and I want to get the oils out of the spices.
Like so. Okay. So that's there. These two pans. The reason why they're on is in here. We've got this amazing cauliflower sprouting. So you've probably seen broccoli sprouting, but this is available at the moment. So why not use it?
Question from your old school mate, Guy. Simon, when are you
going to
get yourself on Saturday Kitchen?
When I get invited. Nice to see you, Guy. Just connect us. I don't know how many years. That must be 30. Jesus. Okay, so that goes in. Hey, Guy is an amazing... I'm going to get this wrong, Guy, so forgive me. He's a horticulturist and works in one of the national trust places. I think he's in charge of it all. So, Guy, tell us, can you tell us who he works with? So, our cauliflower is going in. I love this stuff. We don't need to make it really soft. We want to get a bit of colour for a bit of interest, a bit of imagination. We want to keep some of the white. So we're just going to leave it like that. I was going to use this coconut oil, I forgot. I'll put it in there, into the spices. So a little bit of coconut oil is going to go in. Okay, I'm going to crank the heat up so we get a little bit more heat in there. Melt that. Okay, it's making a right hold mess. I'm going to now put a little bit of garlic in. I don't want to burn the garlic, I'm going to put it in a little bit later. And it's going to be having a skin problem, you see, totally ruining it. So a little bit of garlic. Nobody wants burnt garlic, it's not nice. But also, nobody wants to be tasting garlic for the rest of the day. So a little bit of garlic for a flavour, some interest. Out here I've got some beautiful beans, which I have blended. So I kept them. There's a mixed bag of beans which you can buy dry. Don't buy tins. Tins lazy. Buy dry, soak them overnight. And just blanch them in a bit of salted water. It's really simple, but really good for you. If you're like me, trying to lose a bit of weight, trying to maybe not eat so much meat, but then you know, replace them with some good beans. I'm going to put a handful of beans in, like so. And now I'm going to put a little bit of miso in there. This is very savoury. It's kind of like a... lovely. Tell us what's the word I'm thinking. Umami, aren't they? It's going to give it a lovely seasoned balance, and it's awesome and it's more like very Moorish, using a lot of Asian countries. Smelling really good. Sorry, Ben, you can have a little look at these now. I'll leave them a bit more colour, and then we'll drop them. So here's a little This is called a nage, okay? It's a vegetable stock. So you can get these in a little cube, stock cubes. But actually, you can make this very simple. Trimmings, carrots, onions, fennel, garlic, a bunch of herbs, the stalks from the herbs. Just put them in the water, put them in a pot, top them up with water, bring it to the boil, take it off, okay? And just leave it. And it's unbelievable. The smell is unbelievable. Beautiful, clean, fresh cooking liquid. So what we've done here is we've roasted them, the cauliflower, but now we're just going to just finish them with a little bit of stock. Good question. Two good questions. The first one, I will say, I think the actual meal kits are now sold out, but the event itself online is... fancy meeting myself and Thomas, who's our guest chef. I think tickets are available. We'll get something up online, yeah. And then the second one is on the 13th of March, and I am still securing a chef because everyone's busy. But if you're a chef and you've got a meal kit service, come and get in touch. I've actually had Ben Fishburne, love that. Okay, so here we are. I need to season
the cauliflower. Thank you. A little bit of salt, not too much. Thank you, Ben. I want to add a bit of crunch, a bit of freshness to this, so I'm going to use a fennel to do that. If you don't like, if you've never tried fennel, it's got a, kind of got an acidic, aniseed, thank you. But with this we want it quite thin, okay? So I'm going to just almost shave it nice and thin, okay? You can just cut out that if you're a little bit careful with the knife. Okay. I forgot my large chopping knife. If anyone's out there going, why don't you use a bigger knife? Idiot. Okay, so a little bit of that. Okay. And also, I want a load of herbs. So I've got some mint. I've got fresh mint. Okay. Just stick it on the board. This is tarragon. Again, it's got that kind of slightly aniseedy sort of taste. Beautiful. Used a lot in France. You just give that a little toss for this chap.
Absolutely.
Thank you. Parsley. I love parsley. When I smell parsley, I think of my grandmother's back door because she used to go there making to freshen up a fresh chicken soup or something. This is thyme. And then we've got some chives, which we'll do in a minute. We're going to bunch them together just once. Okay, they're not just like a little green fleck. It's actually a big part of the dish. Lots of herbs. I think herbs are a bit like the lead guitar in a fantastic song. You know, you've got an amazing tone, you've got the bass, you've got the drums, you've got the rhythm guitar, a bit of keyboard in there, and then we throw in a bit of lead guitar just to finish it all off. So that's where we're at.
Another question?
Yeah.
This is an amazing live stream. Are you planning any more?
Yes. Trying to understand how to do it. Yes, actually we are, loads. We want to do more and more live stuff. We've been doing some stuff over Christmas, and that worked really well, and so I think that we're going to try and do more and more. And in fact, I have quite a schedule of events, so every month we will do a feast event. So we'll do a feast event, and then we're also going to do Bring to the Boil, which is kind of like a podcast, kind of question and answer thing. And then I think two live streams, so one on a Monday, which is about healthy Mondays, and then one other, which I can't remember what I'm doing.
Thursdays.
That's the third five kind of masterclass, yeah. Cool. I think we're good. I'm going to add a touch of salt just to moisten this up. Okay, I'm going to now add a little bit of lemon juice. Fresh, of course. So, freshly squeezed lemon. A drop of olive oil. Oops. And I'm going to give it a little taste. Neutral. And a little bit more miso. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put some of this into here. I'm going to put a little bit of cauliflower in there just to kind of give us a little bit of some of the little bit of dressing in there, taste. Last minute, I'm going to put all my fennel and the herbs. Thank you. And then I'll just turn that around. Put a bit in the middle. Whoops. Get some of that fennel for a little bit of height. Pop a little bit more cauliflower in.
Oh, yes.
And then a couple of little bits of the chili around. But just to kind of give us a little bit of the sense of this stock that we use, just to moisten the whole dish up. Now you could actually put a lot more of this in, Ben. You could put it in a bowl or something like that. And we'll just finish it with a touch of olive oil.
Question?
Yeah?
When will you teach your amazing shepherd's pie with lavender mashed potatoes? I miss it.
I keep thinking
thinking my mum's buying all these, but she doesn't know that. So here's Ben's dish.
The other Ben.
Now this is the one that we made earlier on, so he probably needs about an hour, about 180, 160 I'd say. Be careful of that topping. And actually, it's actually better the next day, because when it cools down and you reheat it, it's unbelievable, this dish. But if you come closer, you'll listen to this. It's crispy, really crispy, baked and beautiful. So, what we're going to try and do is cut a nice piece all around. Just so we can make sure we get it. Big spoon. Might need a bit of help here. And that is beautiful. Now it's not quite as like Ben's picture in the book, but have a little look. You can see the layers there. I've got some lovely basil. And I'm just going to. Again, just fresh. You don't need to chop everything up here. Just so we've got a little bit of basil going on. Maybe a couple of leaves here. Again, just a little splash of olive oil. I think, because we've got this amazing Parmesan cheese,
so, Ben, thank you so much.
Welcome.
Come in. Introduce your dish. This is aubergine parmigiana. Done fantastic. Finish up.
So this is the slightly reworked and the Aston's, where it's actually mung bean and asparagus salad, that's what it's meant to be. But again, going into the market this morning, we found these amazing cauliflower. So it's just a warm cauliflower bean salad with a slight Middle Eastern type twist to it.
Yeah. Classic Italian dish, bang full of vitamins, bang full of minerals that you need, all good when everybody's locked away. And it's a feel-good dish as well,
yep.
which is a kind of
I'll go from this side, you go from that side.
So, let's have a quick taste.
That's awesome. It's quite soft in its texture, but I think it's better that way. Really lovely. So, National Apprenticeship Week. Are you thinking about changing your career? Are you thinking about coming out of school or even college and not knowing quite what you want to do? You can come to Beyond Food, come down to Brigade when we're reopened, but Beyond Food online, and we will be more than happy to answer some questions. And our apprenticeship starts in July, so we'll be looking to recruit people in April. Please, rather than give you loads of different places to go to, and just come to Beyond Food's new website. It's Beyond Food. Beyondfood.org.uk, and there's everything there. You can get everything about our programs, about us as people, about our ambitions to try and help vulnerable people, and also other people get into long-term employment. Please share this live stream. It's really important to us. It's only a few people on it today, but it's because that's our first one, but we want to get more and more people on today. So thank you, Ben. Thank you, everyone behind us here who's socially distanced, I promise, and we'll see you next time. Bye.